next morning,
what the heck is this? Car chaos, bottoms up, and I think we're gonna need more than aloe for this. Today we're back at it, breaking down all of the creative medical scenes and wild ways people supposedly kick the bucket in 1,000 ways to die. Here to help me react is my wife, Jen.
Hello. For those of you who do not know, I used to be an actress on this show. Hopefully it doesn't get too weird today.
Let's dive right in.
Hello.
Yeah. Never good.
Back to work. Uh-oh. Hey, boy.
Jolene was a 4-star tease.
I feel like she probably didn't even need construction done on her house. They're
right.
Like, hey.
Looks like they're fixing her driveway or sidewalk or something.
Yeah.
Help me out. I could use some suntan
lotion. Oh my. I love that there's a lounger right where they're working.
I always keep my lounger in the front lawn.
It's like a backyard private thing.
Your pool, maybe.
Swimming pools.
But when you're an object of mass distraction, you leave yourself open to attack.
Oh! What exploded? Whatever it was, severed her literally in half. It almost looks like the spine is even severed. Oh my God. What? Come on!
Come on!
We still have some attachment of the intestines. There'd probably be a lot more blood, but that's okay. Probably bleed out and die pretty damn fast.
That many organs are exposed.
It's more the aorta, it's more the bleeding.
Would you kick the bucket that fast?
Minutes, not like seconds.
Poor Jolene.
This gang of intellectually challenged 20-somethings drained their trust funds on fashion accessories and muscle cars.
I love the muscle cars, not gonna lie.
Muscle cars aren't really a thing anymore.
When I was in high school, there was a group of guys and they all had like Chevelles, Novas. They all had really cool old muscle cars.
Mike and Jay saw themselves as the Sid and Nancy of the group, who didn't have an orifice that wasn't pierced and didn't know a line they wouldn't cross.
Didn't have an orifice that wasn't pierced. You can, pretty much pierce any tissue.
Yeah. What's an orifice by orifice, medical definition?
Orifice is just a hole, a natural hole.
Step into my orifice.
Do you have any piercings that I need to know about?
No piercings here. They're gonna get caught. Stuck.
Oh no.
The kiss of death.
When I had my belly button ring, it used to get caught on my pants all the time and like rip. And then once I had my cartilage in my ear pierced.
Yep.
And my hairdresser ripped it out.
They don't heal well because it's cartilage and there's not as much blood flow.
The two lovers remained lip locked until the last possible moment when the cars would pull away to avoid a stationary object.
So not smart.
In this case, a slow moving forklift.
Oh my God.
The stunt would have worked. Except Mike and Jade suddenly found themselves
stuck,
tongue-tied.
Why wouldn't you just pull the other person into the car? Again, these split-second decisions that people just are not used to making.
Have you had anybody come into the emergency room where people were stuck to other people?
Not me. I've heard of stories, but no, I haven't seen it. Anytime piercings are an issue, it's usually like caught or like stuck inside your own tissue.
Get back in the
awful. Traumatic brain, head injury, head's exploding probably. That's brains everywhere, maybe even decapitated.
You've seen these competitions
yeah.
on TV.
And now rectal prolapse, no?
Why is he even killed?
He's on the verge of
He's gonna
victory.
Fall on him?
Oh no.
But the strain becomes too much.
If you're pushing that hard in your head, couldn't like an aneurysm pop?
You could if you already had an aneurysm. An aneurysm is just a weakening of the wall of your artery, basically. When you have too much pressure in that area, that spot can pop.
And the Scotsman bottoms out.
I knew his rectum was coming out. A rectal prolapse.
You've seen it.
Yeah, a couple times.
A number of times.
Yeah. Normally, it just kind of comes out anywhere between like an inch to like 3 or 4 inches. Oh my, this is a horribly false depiction.
Is that what it looks like?
No.
It was like a whole kielbasa sausage.
Don't refer to it as food.
Okay, what are the main causes? I need to avoid certain activities.
Straining.
Okay, that's why I don't lift heavy weights.
Straining. This is a ton. This is like the whole descending colon coming out. But it wouldn't kill you. You could maybe rip it and maybe bleed to death, but that would take a while.
What do you do? do?
You do want to get it back in. It will bleed. It's mucosal tissue. Manual manipulation, so you're basically just putting it in with pressure, and then sometimes people need to go to the operating room. Once you've had it done, it can happen again.
Shelly was the kind of roommate who acted as if everything was hers. One of her roommates recently bought a tanning bed.
Cool.
What?
I mean, it's cool, but not good for you. Bad for your skin.
Very bad for your skin.
Ages it. It increases wrinkles just for the look of tanning.
I used to go every day for a hot minute. Now I just do the spray on tan.
Yeah.
Relatively safer. Probably still not good for you,
right.
But.
A lesser of two evils.
No one was supposed to go near it.
Just gonna get stuck in it.
Lived in it.
There have been some studies, if you're in it for like 2 minutes, it's actually beneficial. People who get seasonal, like depression due to not seeing the sun, this is actually good for them as well. In short bursts, not to where you're actually tanning. Oh. So you have to be careful not protecting your eyes in these because of scarring and increases your risk of getting cataracts. So just be careful.
On this day, she fell asleep while tanning and got more than she bargained for.
Okay.
Just a bad sunburn, she thought.
Oh my gosh. Bad sunburn is basically a level 1. It's a first degree burn. 2 is when you actually start having blisters.
Aloe. Yogurt. I think you can put yogurt.
Cool baths, anything, just symptomatically. It's gonna have to run its course no matter what.
She popped some of her roomie's painkillers to sleep it off. The next morning.
What the heck is this? Second degree burns hurt like heck.
Because your nerves aren't gone?
Correct. You feel everything. And then, because now all these blisters are popped open, you have a massive increased risk of infection and increased risk of a lot of dehydration because you don't have the normal regulatory mechanisms of your skin.
Wait, she took her friend's Turns medication. She woke up with...
Shelly, have you seen my cream?
This looks horrible.
Her roommate's psoriasis medication. It contained psoriline, a chemical that makes skin highly sensitive to light and heat.
Some antibiotics we give people, we're like, please be careful. It's gonna make you more sensitive to the sun. It's gonna maybe make you burn more.
While knocked out on painkillers, the psoriline turned her tanning bed sunburn into second degree burns across her entire body.
Wow. Would the painkiller have contributed that?
No, all the painkiller did was cover up the fact that she was progressing in the process of the sunburn. So if you would have noticed sooner, maybe you would have gotten to the hospital sooner.
Shelly, painkillers?
She collapsed into her roommate's arms, dead from heart failure.
Dead from heart failure. Could be related to dehydration. You can break down a lot of your cells, leading to high potassium levels, which can cause cardiac arrhythmias and go into cardiac arrest. Or the breakdown of all your tissue can clog up your kidneys, backup of your body's toxins. Very interesting. These are always good. I know we get comments all the time where people are like, oh, that's fake, that's show, blah, blah, blah.
Listen, they might have taken a little bit of creative liberty. That's fine. Makes for interesting medical conversations.
That's right. Also, big new things on the horizon. Check out my brand new supplement company, Life Happens. If you guys enjoyed this, definitely check out this playlist right here. And as always, please make sure you subscribe, turn your bell notifications on, and hit that like button. Thank you so much for watching.
And stay healthy, my friends.